family Lamias, and the old name is Labiate. And this family is also known as mint family. All the plants are belongs to this family are important for its flavor, fragrance, and its medicinal property. The plants belongs to this family are osimum, or tulsi, mint, salvia, thyme, rosemary. All are herbs or medicinal herbs. First, the habitat of this plant. Some are herbs, some are shrubs. Herbs, in case of osimum and mint, they are herbs. And some are annual herbs and some are perennial. Annual means the plants which lives for a single season, and perennial which lives for years together or long years, that is called perennial plants. Then we'll describe from the stem. Stem having aromatic smell due to essential oil present in the glandular hair. The surface of the stem is covered by hairs, and this due to these glandular hairs, there is this aromatic smell on the stem, on the leaf, there is some flavor. And the stems are rectangular, and in case of mentha, there is presence of underground sucker. Next is leaf. Leaves are opposite and decussate. Opposite means from a single node. This is called opposite position. If the leaf arises on both sides from a single node, this is opposite. And decussate, gradually the leaves are smaller towards the apex. This is a small leaves or smaller leaves towards apex. This is the decussate arrangement. This one is larger leaves, then gradually smaller. This is the decussate arrangement. Then exstipulate with hairs and aromatic smell on the leaf. Exstipulate means on the base of the stalk. This is the stem, this is the petiole, this is called petiole. If any outgrowth at the base of the or the junction of the stem and the petiole, this is called stipule. So here the stipules are absent, so it is exstipulate. With hairs and aromatic smell means again there is a flavor or fragrance in the leaf and the stem. Entire means the surface of the or the margin of the leaf is smooth. This is called entire margin. Unicostate reticulate. Uni means single, costa means vein. This is the single mid vein is unicostate. Reticulate means net like venation. These are the veins or which are in net like manner. This is called unicostate means single mid vein, and reticulate venation means net like venation. Then inflorescence. Inflorescence is verticillustre. This is the inflorescence in case of Labiate. And verticillustre means from a single node, both sides, there arise a condensed dicaceal sac. Dicaceal sac means from this node, again the leaf flower, a leaf arises from this side, this side, this side, and this is a dicaceal sign. This is called monocaceal sign, where one side leaf, dicaceal, both sides having leaf. So this is a condensed form of dicaceal sign on the single node. This is called verticillustre inflorescence. Flowers pedicellate or sessile. Pedicellate means flowers having stalk. If the flowers having a definite stalk, this is called pedicel or pedicellate flower. And if the stalk is absent, this is called sessile flower. So some are having pedicel and some are sessile flowers. Bracteate. Bract present. If this is the flower, this is the position of bract. So bracts are present, so this is bracteate. Complete. Complete means all the four holes are present. Four holes. If four holes present, then it is complete. So what are the four holes? Calyx, corolla, androecium and gynoecium. If all four holes are present, then it is a complete flower. Zygomorphic flowers are mainly present in this family, but rarely there is actinomorphic flower. Zygomorphic means if the flower is divided into only one vertical plane, into two equal half, that is zygomorphic. And these zygomorphic flowers can be seen by seeing the unequal petals. If the flowers having unequal petals, then it is a zygomorphic flower. Actinomorphic flowers having all equal petals. So rarely there is actinomorphic flowers, but mostly they are zygomorphic. And hermaphrodite. Hermaphrodite means bisexual. If both the two are present, androecium and gynoecium, then it is hermaphrodite. Rarely unisexual flowers are present. Rarely the flowers are being single stamen or gynoecium. So male flowers or female flowers are present very rarely in this family. We are talking about the family. So some are bisexual. Very rarely there is unisexual flowers are also there. Pentameras. Pentameras means if the number of sepal, petal or stamen, there is a number as 5 or multiple of 5, then it is called pentameras. Hypogynous. Hypogynous means superior ovary. If this is the gynoecium, stigma, style, ovary, and this is the receptacle or thalamus. The calyx, corolla, androecium all arises below ovary. This is calyx, corolla, androecium arises below ovary, then it is called hypogynous or superior ovary. Next is calyx. Calyx, number of sepal 5. Calyx, number of sepal 5. And that is bilabiate condition. Bilabiate means two lips are there. The sepals are arranged in two lips. In case of Osima, the arrangement is 1+4. That means four petal sepals united to form one lip and another large sepal is present. They are forming two lipped or two labiate. That is called bilabiate condition. Gamosepalus and valvate or imbricate estivation. Imbricate estivation. And in some flowers, the arrangement is 2+3. This is 2+3 in case of mentha. So the 5 sepals are arranged in 2 lipped or this is called bilabiate condition. So it may be 1+4 like Osima or in Osima, 2+3 in mentha. Then corolla. In corolla also, the number of petals is 5 and they are arranged in bilabiate condition. Corolla, number of petal 5, but they are arranged in 4+1, opposite to the sepal. And this 4 petals united to form one lip, another is larger petal. And here also the estivation is valvate or imbricate. And this corolla form a tubular structure at the base. Tubular base and they form two lipped having four petals united to form one leaf, another large petal. Next comes to androecium. Number of stamens 4, and these are 2+2 and one reduced stamen that is represented as staminode. And the number of stamen is 4. That is didynamous condition. Didynamous, 2 perfect stamen and 2 imperfect stamen. These are supposed to equal length 2 stamen, another 2 stamens are small. So basically number of stamen 5. So one is reduced stamen, which is represented as staminode. So number of stamen is 4, didynamous or 2+2, and one is represented as staminode. And dithecus, this is called dithecus anther. Anther is bilobed or dithecus. And introse means this is a filament, and this is the filament attached to the end of the lobe. That is called introse condition. Next, gynoecium. Number of carpel 2, syncarpus means fused carpel, and hypogynous, again it is superior ovary. So gynoecium is here. At the base of the gynoecium, calyx, corolla, androecium all arises below ovary. So this is hypogynous. Bilocular means two chambered ovary. Mainly the ovary is two chambered, and this is called bilocular. Locule means chamber, and it is divided by a false septum into four chambered. It becomes four chambered due to presence of a false septum. Basically it is bilocular, and due to presence of a false septum it is divided into four chambered or tetralocular. And the style is gynobasic style, means this is the style and attached to the base of the ovary, and it is called gynobasic style. This is the lobes of ovary, and the style attached to the base of the ovary is gynobasic style. And bilobed stigma. Stigma is two-lobed. Then floral formula. Floral formula BR or bracteate, and this sign, this is percentage sign for zygomorphic flower, bisexual flower, calyx 3+2 in some flowers and 1+4 in some flowers. So it may be 3-2 or 1-4. Corolla again 2-3 or 4-1, 2+3 or 4+1. Number of corolla petal is 5, but they are arranged in two-lipped or bilabiate condition. So this may be 2-3 condition or 4-1 condition. Number of stamen 2+2, that is didynamous, another is staminode or reduced stamen. Gynoecium, number of carpel 2, syncarpa, so bracket, and superior ovary, there is a bar below G. And epipetalous, so above A and C, there is a bar that is called epipetalous condition. Epipetalous means stamens attached to the base of the corolla tube. Next comes to, this is the structure of flower. This is calyx, and these are the two lip. This is one lip, another lip. And this one is a larger sepal, and this is having four sepal united to form one lip. So this is called bilabiate condition. Next, to the opposite, larger sepal, there is four petals united to form one lip. This is the one lip of petal or corolla. Another is larger petal. So this is the position. If this is the sepal, one larger sepal, then four small petals united to form the lip, and in case of four sepals, and this is the larger petal. And this is the structure of gynoecium. This is called gyno basic style. These are the four lobes which are seen from the ovary, or externally it is seen that having four lobes, and the base, the gynoecium attached to the base of the ovary. Next comes to floral diagram. This is the floral diagram of Osimum sanctum. This is called Tulsi. So this is sepal, is number of sepal 5, and they are arranged in 1+4. So this is one large sepal, and these are the four sepals united to form one leaf. So this is gamosepalous condition. So all the sepals are attached, and these are four small sepals. This is one large sepal. Again, opposite to this, four small petals. These are the four small petals united to form one leaf. Another, this one is large petal. This is one leaf, this is another leaf. Number of stamen, four, didynamous. So from this side, a pair of stamen, from this, another pair, and this position is staminode or reduced stamen. And TS of ovary shows it is false septum, and it is bilocular chamber, but due to false septum, it is looks tetralocular or four chamber. So this is the floral diagram. So main important plants are tulsi, which is having medicinal value, thyme, rosemary, mint, and salvia. All these plants having medicinal value or herbal plants, and these are important for their medicinal use. So this is all about Amelie Lamiaceae, or old name is Labia.